Hello friends. So in the previous 2-3 sessions, we have been going through the concept of power factor correction by the synchronous motor. Okay. So today let us talk about a device which is called a synchronous capacitor or a synchronous condenser. Okay. So what you have seen in the previous session is that a synchronous motor, when overexcited, can supply reactive power to the system, right? And you saw that there were a lot of advantages, like reduction in the current through the transmission line, reduction of the power loss in the transmission line, and also stability advantage. But in the numerical, you saw that the synchronous motor was actually consuming a reactive real power of 150 kilowatt. That means it was driving some kind of a load. But sometimes synchronous motors are purchased with the sole purpose of power factor correction. Okay, so they are not going to drive any load. They will be in their no load condition, and they will be just driving a. They will be just used to do some power factor correction. I'm sorry if you are able to hear some drums from the outside because the Ganesh festival is going on, so people are going to do their visarjan. But I will try to eliminate some thing from the noise. But anyway, sorry for that. I hope you can bear that. Okay. And so what we are discussing here is that the synchronous motor can supply reactive power when overexcited condition, and in some industries actually the synchronous motor is purchased only for this power factor correction. There the synchronous motor does not drive any load, it is in the no load condition. Okay, so I'll write down that point also. Sometimes synchronous motors were purchased and made to run in no load, okay, made to run in no load simply for power factor correction. Okay, so to see what happens when the synchronous motor is under no load condition, overexcited synchronous motor is a low load condition, we have to draw the phasor diagram, right? Now in the no load condition, we can assume that the real power drawn by the system is zero. And if you assume that the resistance of the synchronous motor is zero, you can neglect the losses also. Okay, so there is no active component of current which is present. Okay, so that means if the power output is equal to zero, that means Ea sin delta will be equal to zero and Ia cos theta is equal to zero. Okay, because power is equal to 3 Ea V phase sin delta divided by Xs, right? So if power has to be zero, consumption has to be zero, this Ea cannot be zero because Ea is a function of k, phi and omega. So if omega and flux are present, Ea will be existing. So the only component which can be zero is Ea sin delta. Okay, together Ea and sin delta has to be zero. So if Ea sin delta is zero, naturally that means Ea cannot be equal to zero. That means delta is equal to zero. So if you draw the phasor diagram, you can see it something like this. So this is the value of V phase. Okay. Now because it's an overexcited generator and because delta equal to zero, Ea and V phase will be in the same line. Okay. So this will be the value of Ea. And you know that the equation is V phase is equal to Ea plus J into Ia into Xs. Okay. So J, or you can write V phase is equal to So Ea, and what will be the direction of J into Ia into Xs? It will be in this direction, right? J into Ia into Xs will be in this direction. So this is J into Ia into Xs, okay? Because you know that J into Ia into Xs in synchronous motor is from Ea to V phase, not V phase to Ea. It is from Ea to V phase. That you can see in the phasor diagram. Now if J into Ia into Xs is in this direction, naturally the current will be in this direction, lagging to this, right? So if you take a small amount of current, okay, very small amount, naturally because it's in no load condition, these values will be very small. Okay, so this value is going to be very small, but you can see that here the current Ia is leading V phase by 90 degrees. Okay, so this is very similar to a capacitive action. Okay, so it is very similar to a capacitive action. Okay, so the synchronous motor is basically behaving like a capacitor. Okay, so an overexcited synchronous motor, synchronous motor, especially when it's in the no load condition, acts like a large capacitive bank. Okay, large capacitive bank connected to the power system. Why? Because the current was leading the voltage by 90 degree. Okay, so that was the advantage here. Now, in some cases, what happens is that, so in the previous case, you saw that when we are discussing the numerical, the synchronous motor was driving some load. In some cases, the synchronous motors are designed specifically for power this power factor correction. So in that case, you will not have a shaft which is coming out in which you can put load. It will not have a shaft which is coming out of the frame of the machine. Okay, and such synchronous motors which are designed specifically for power factor correction are called synchronous condensers or synchronous capacitors. Condenser is an old name for capacitor. Okay, so I'll write down that point also here. So in some cases, the synchronous motor was specifically designed. Okay, designed for power factor correction. Okay, for power factor correction. That is, it did not have a shaft coming out of the frame of the machine, Okay, so what is the meaning of that? It could not be loaded. So it will be always in the no load condition. So synchronous condensers, because there is no provision to load the synchronous motor, so synchronous condensers will be always in the no load condition. Okay, so such machines are called synchronous condensers or synchronous capacitors. Okay, so these are basically synchronous machines which are specifically designed for power factor correction, and they run at no load condition, because in the no load condition they have a very similar property to that of a capacitive bank which is connected to the power system. So what will be the V curve of such a system? So for a V curve for a synchronous condenser, okay, I hope you remember what is a V curve. V curve for a synchronous condenser. Okay, synchronous condenser. So here you have to remember that IA is approximately will be equal to 0. Okay, so if you see what is power is equal to V3 into V phase into IA into cos theta. Okay, so in the UPF condition, so if you see at UPF 3 into V phase into IA, right? So cos theta is equal to 1 in UPF. So if IA is approximately equal to 0, if the real power, because the synchronous motor is in the no load condition, power will be approximately equal to 0, real power consumed will be approximately equal to 0. That means IA will be approximately equal to 0. Therefore, in the V curve, you are having two conditions, right? Lag condition, leaked condition, and UPF. Okay, so this is the field current and this is the armature current. Okay, so the armature current will start in the leading condition somewhere around here, and it will drop sharply like this because there is no load which is connected. Okay, it's in the no load condition, and it can increase in the lead condition as IF goes increases, IA will increase in like this, and at one particular point it may reach its saturation. Okay, so this is the saturation point. So at UPF condition, IA is absolutely equal to 0 because the real power consumed by the system is 0. And why is real power consumed equal to 0? Because it is in the no load condition, synchronous motor in the no load condition. Here IA is contributed by the reactive power, and here also IA is contributed by the demand for reactive power. Okay, and so here there is no reactive power is equal to 0 in UPF, and because there is no load, real power is equal to 0. So this is the V curve of a synchronous condenser. So this is in the lag condition and this is in the lead condition. And I told you this current is to contribute for the reactive power in both cases. Okay, so nowadays actually synchronous condensers are not much in use, because nowadays static capacitive banks are much economical cost effective. Okay. And then you don't have the hassle of installing a synchronous motor. Okay. You are having static machines, synchronous motors are rotating machine, right? So nowadays capacitive banks are very much cheaper as compared to installing a synchronous motor. Okay. So I hope today you have understood the lecture. So today, because basically we saw a device which is called a synchronous condenser, which is basically a synchronous motor under overexcited synchronous motor under the no load condition. So if you have liked this video, please like, share and subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to recommend these videos with your friends or any other people who are finding difficulty in understanding all these subjects, because this channel contains multiple topics like engineering circuit analysis, DC motors, synchronous generators, and now synchronous motors running. So till I see you in the next video, it's me Varun signing off, and have a great day. Thank you.